I selected the morphology class because I knew while in lecture we were talking mostly about like evolution of everything. The lab would be mostly hands-on, it'd be anatomy, we'd be dissecting things. There's so many terms, so many vocabulary words that we have to know, it's ridiculous. I mean, our first lab practical, we had to know every single bone of the cat and then learn every nook and cranny on the bone because that's where the muscles are attached to. So we're like, what? There's a lot of muscles to know, and we also have to know where they start and where they insert on the bone, origin and insertion, and plus we have to know the function. At least it's hands-on, because we can tug the muscle. You can see what gives slack and what doesn't give slack, so you can find the origin and you can find the insertion points. There's little sheets of paper right next to it, and say, what is this? And it's just a free-for-all. That's what's really cool. We had a bone in a bag, and was a bone in a pillowcase, and you couldn't look, and you had to feel what it was. But you're like, this feels like a transverse process. God, I really want to look, but I can't. You just have to feel it, so it's pretty cool. I look at cats different now. Now that I've, like, you know, studied their bones, know a little bit of their muscles, know their organs, we're going to learn their circulatory system later. I know how that cat walks. I know how that cat moves, and that's pretty exciting to me. And this is how we're learning. They're there for our teaching instruction and purposes, and if you're going to go into a medical field, you might as well get used to it. I mean, it looks exactly like our insides. It really does.